Sherlock Holmes is the original great detective. His legacy has lived for over 100 years, and his brilliance has surpassed that of other detectives. Not only was he incredibly popular when he first appeared in the late 1800s, but he has stayed popular and stayed a staple in popular culture, even up to today. Sherlock Holmes was created by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle with A Study in Scarlet, which was published in 1887 with illustrations by Sidney Paget. Most of the stories appeared in the Strand magazine. In 1893, Doyle tried to kill off Holmes after getting tired of writing the stories. This caused public outrage. The popularity of the stories was so great that after publication of The Final Problem, in which Sherlock Holmes apparently plunges to his death, Doyle even got letters accusing him of murder. Eventually, public demand and the money from the stories was so lucrative that he began to write Sherlock stories once more, and continued writing until 1927. The stories have lasted centuries, with Sherlock Holmes becoming a household name in detectives. There have been countless radio programs, movies, and television shows, some as recent as this year. For this information and more, check out www.sherlock-holmes.org.uk. Even now, Sherlock Holmes is a household name. There have been hundreds of adaptations of the original Sir Arthur Conan Doyle stories, from Basil Rathbone, probably one of the more well-known portrayers of Sherlock Holmes, to Benedict Cumberbatch, who plays Sherlock in the new BBC series that has updated the stories to modern London. On top of the BBC Sherlock, there have been recent movies, such as Sherlock Holmes and the sequel Sherlock Holmes Game of Shadows, both starring Robert Downey Jr. as Sherlock and Jude Law as Watson. All the adaptations of Sherlock have much the same features as the original stories. Sherlock is always brilliant and oftentimes condescending. He is usually proficient in boxing and swordsmanship and other forms of hand-to-hand combat. He usually has to go up against James, or Jim, Moriarty, the consulting criminal to his consulting detective. That's just modern adaptations of the actual Sherlock character. Traits of the great detective have permeated through to modern detective stories and modern detectives themselves. The original Sherlock Holmes stories were so well written that even in today's modern Sherlock adaptations, whole chunks of dialogue are taken directly from the stories. This is an example from the first Sherlock Holmes story, A Study in Scarlet, from Chapter 2, page 12 of the Barnes & Noble leatherback published book, The Complete Sherlock Holmes. In this excerpt, Sherlock and Watson have just met, and Sherlock is explaining what he does and how he does it. "Observation with me is second nature. You appeared to be surprised when I told you on our first meeting that you had come from Afghanistan. You were told, no doubt." "Nothing of the sort. I knew you came from Afghanistan. From long habit, the train of thoughts ran so swiftly through my mind that I arrived at the conclusion without being conscious of steps. There were such steps, however. The train of reasoning ran, 'Here's a gentleman of a medical type, but with the air of a military man. Clearly an army doctor, then. He has just come from the tropics, for his face is dark, and that is not the natural tone of his skin, for his wrists are fair. He has undergone hardship and sickness, as his haggard face says clearly. His left arm has been injured. He holds it in a stiff and unnatural manner. Where in the tropics could an English army doctor have seen such hardship and got his arm wounded? Clearly in Afghanistan.' The whole train of thought did not occupy a second. I then remarked that you came from Afghanistan and you were astonished." Sherlock pulls the same kind of routine when he meets John Watson in the BBC rendition of the show entitled Sherlock. The show is created by Stephen Moffat and Mark Gatiss, and starring Benedict Cumberbatch as Sherlock Holmes and Martin Freeman as John Watson. It first aired in 2010. In the first episode, A Study in Pink, he meets John in the hospital and is immediately able to tell some key things about him, like that he was a soldier in Afghanistan or Iraq, and that he has a psychosomatic limp, that he didn't get along with his sibling. All this he was able to pull out of minute details that he observed in split seconds. When he breaks down how he figured these things out for John, John was amazed and astounded. He has the same reaction in this show as he does in the books. Throughout the television program, when Sherlock shows he's detecting progress, John frequently says fantastic, or amazing, or some such adjective, which is the same sort of reaction he frequently emotes in the books. Batman is a Sherlockian type character. He is able to put small pieces of information together and make accurate conclusions based on his observations. By doing this, he is able to anticipate and circumvent the villainous plans of his arch-nemesis. Very Sherlock Holmes of him. Psych is one of the many modern detective shows that has a Sherlock archetype for a character. There are countless cases in popular television where the detectives have the deductive skills that Sherlock so often displays. Psych is one of the most interesting because it actually highlights the different objects that the main character Sean Spencer sees. So if the viewer would like, they are able to follow along through the crime-solving process and try to piece the information that Sean sees together along with him in order to solve the crime. Batman and Robin are a great example of modern characters that take after Sherlock Holmes. Batman is extremely observant and is able to solve mysteries and crimes. In the DC comic book universe, he's even known as the Great Detective. To continue with the comparison, he has his own Watson and Robin, an assistant that he trains to help him solve his mysteries. As far as partners go, the dynamic duo is his famous Sherlock Holmes and John Watson. Batman was first published in 1939 and has remained a staple hero since then. The comics are published by DC and the original stories are being republished in chronological order in volumes called the Batman Chronicles. Volume 1 includes the introduction of Batman and his backstory, the introduction of Robin, and even the introduction of the most infamous of Batman's enemies, the Joker. It contains Batman stories from Detective Comics number 27 through 38 and Batman number 1. The USA Network show Psych is going on its 7th season, and it revolves around a character that is hyper-observant. Sean Spencer has a photographic memory, and the series starts out with him phoning tips into the cops that solve cases. But then the cops call him in for questioning and accuse him of being an accomplice, knowing information he could have only gotten on the inside. Sean, in an attempt to come up with a way out of it after the police refuse to listen, says that he's psychic. The police end up hiring him as a consultant, and he and his best friend and partner Gus solve mysteries together, with Sean pretending to be psychic all the while. Sean solves his mysteries by noticing out-of-the-way details and putting them together, but announces them by having extravagant, exaggerated psychic episodes. He has the same observation and deduction skills as Sherlock Holmes. Once again, we see a partner that could be comparable to Watson and Gus. Gus is more level-headed than Sean and more grounded, but he gets a thrill out of helping him on his cases and being part of the detective agency, much the same as the thrill that level-headed, practical Watson gets out of helping Sherlock. For more information on Psych, visit www.usanetwork.com. Sherlock Holmes is a character that is so popular, he is having new television programs and movies made about him as recently as this year. As they have shown, other popular culture characters have roots in the Sherlock Holmes stories. No matter what faith Sherlock has, or even what name, the idea of this brilliant detective has crossed cultural lines and has lasted over a century.